Hey, what's up? I am MuchelleB and this video is all about breaking bad habits. How to do it. Bad habits are those things that you do on a consistent, habitual basis that are actually detrimental to your life, to your health, to how you feel about yourself, to how you feel about life. Your bad habit may be that you wake up and you sit on Facebook for an hour and then look around and you're like, oh, what up? So much time has gone by. Or you could have a bad habit that's a little bit more serious, like smoking, that's affecting your health. So one way that you can break a bad habit is through progressive extremism. So progressive extremism is essentially picking a new kind of extreme identity, then progressively making that identity more extreme. So I'm going to use the example of myself, which I have talked about before. Didn't realize it was progressive extremism, but apparently there is a term for it. So I knew that eventually I wanted to adopt a more plant-based lifestyle, but it felt like a huge step for me. So instead of jumping straight to going plant-based, I started out with 1 year of cutting out all red meat. So I adopted an extreme identity of I don't eat red meat for a year. So the next step of progressive extremism was to cut out white meat as well, so to become vegetarian. The next year, I cut out all dairy products, all animal-based products as a whole. And this year, I'm working towards purchasing cruelty-free products. So that is progressive extremism. It's just adopting a new identity for a period of time and then adopting a more extreme identity and then keeping it going until you get to the point that you want it to get to. So let's look at progressive extremism applied to breaking the habit of going on Facebook. The first step that you might take is to not go on Facebook for the first hour of the day. You're just someone who doesn't believe in social media of a morning. That is a new identity that you've adopted. After that 6 months is up, you might say, I actually don't even use my phone when I'm in my home office or when I'm in my bedroom. So your home office, the place where maybe you study, you write, you do work, has now become a phone and social media free zone, as well as your bedroom. And your bedroom is just a place to sleep and no technology goes into it. The next step in your progressive extremism journey may be that you don't access social media until after 6 p.m. and so on and so forth until you get to a point where you feel happy with your relationship with social media. The next approach that you could take to breaking your bad habit is to get like extremely curious about the habit. If you think back to those times when you've carried out a bad habit, so the times that you've grabbed your phone and scrolled through Facebook for an hour before realizing how much time had gone past. Did you actually pay attention to how you were feeling as you carried that habit out? Really considerately observing the urges that you had to keep on scrolling through Facebook. If you're a normal human being, most likely that's not how you approach your bad habits. The thing about bad habits is that they're generated because your brain feels like it's receiving a reward. It all links back to the cue habit reward system. So the cue for you, it might be like you're feeling slightly lazy. So your brain goes, oh, you know what's gonna make me feel better? If I scroll through Facebook for an hour. You scroll through Facebook for an hour. At some part of that process, you've gotten the reward that your brain was seeking. So that reward might just be the social validation of being on Facebook, of getting the notifications that say, you know, like you're valid and you're liked. So instead of sort of forcing yourself to stop going on Facebook, try looking at yourself from the outside in. So when you receive a notification, mindfully just notice the urge that you get to click on that notification in that moment. Go ahead and scroll through Facebook, but really be mindful about how you're feeling as you scroll through Facebook. So you're kind of revealing to your brain like, hey, as I scroll through, I kind of feel like crap. I'm getting angry at myself because I'm not doing this task over here. Or whatever those negative feelings that you're getting from your bad habit might be. So you're really making the habit disenchanting. You're making your brain realize that, hey, you're not really getting the greatest of rewards out of this. There's probably a better habit that you could build. I'll link a really good TED talk in the description down below in relation to using mindfulness and breaking bad habits. So the next approach that you could take is forcing yourself to decide using the 5-second rule. So as soon as something becomes habitualized, your brain is just automatically taking you through that process of scrolling through your Facebook, grabbing out your cigarette, clicking purchase in the clothes cart online. It's all stuff that your brain no longer decides on, it no longer dwells on. So a bad habit that I got into, and there's definitely some shame associated with it. I got into this awful habit of falling asleep on the couch after watching a TV show or something and not brushing my teeth before I went to bed. So this became something that I would do on any normal night. It wasn't always, but it was certainly something that wasn't out of the ordinary. So my brain started seeing this as like a weird, like, treat yourself yourself. Don't brush your teeth before you go to sleep. Luke would pick me up and he'd carry me to bed like the beautiful human that he is. I'd vaguely think in my mind like, oh, like I should go and brush my teeth. But then my sleepy monkey mind would just be like, oh no, you don't want to do that. You want to go to sleep. Short-term gains. And when I got into that habit, the decision-making part of my brain just started shutting off. So what I decided to do was to force myself to make a decision. Was I or was I not going to brush my teeth? So that decision could be a no, but for the most part, it wasn't. Just by forcing myself to make a decision to formally say, I'm going to do A or I'm going to do B, it forced me to get up and brush my teeth before I went to sleep. So for this approach, you could also use the 5-4-3-2-1 method, which is Mel Robbins. I'll link her TED talk about that in the description below. So basically, it's giving yourself 5 seconds to get up and do the thing. So for that habit, it would be 5-4-3-2-1, get up, brush your teeth, go to bed. And the last way to break a bad habit is to make changes to your environment. So there was this really interesting study that was done on the troops that went to Vietnam. So 20% of these soldiers actually developed an addiction to heroin while they were there. Only 5% of those people that came home actually kept up their heroin addiction. So the rest completely cold turkey gave up heroin. The re-addiction rate when it comes to heroin is incredibly high. So that is an incredibly abnormal statistic. Essentially, the radical change in environment, so the soldier returning to their home to a place where they probably didn't have easy access to heroin, they didn't have any of the triggers around them to use heroin, helped them to completely give up a drug addiction, so an incredibly bad habit, in a snap, like in an instant. So you might not be in a position to move countries and radically change your environment in that way, but you would be in a position to change your environment and remove the general triggers that usually cause your bad habits to come out. You might be in a position to sell your TV so there's literally no TV that you can just switch on and watch. You might be in a position to move the floss in front of your face every single morning so that there is a stronger trigger for you to actually carry that habit out. You might be in a position to turn off your notifications, so remove your triggers that bring out the bad habit that you want to break. So consider what triggers you can remove from your environment that are helping you to carry out your bad habits. I talked a lot more about this in a video that I made on how not to be lazy. It talks actually a lot about breaking bad habits as well, so it'd be a good video to watch in conjunction with this one. I will link it in the description below. So the question of the video today is, what bad habit did you have that you've now broken, and how did you go about that? If you have a story to share, leave it in the comment section down below. Subscribe to my channel for videos on things like behavior design, minimalism, habits, all of that kind of stuff. If you like this video, like I mentioned, you'd probably like my video called How to Be Lazy, so I will link that somewhere on the screen here. I appreciate you guys so very much, and I will see you soon.